So I want to start this video by asking you a question. So as we know, the argon fluoride laser, which is currently used in the industry, it has a wavelength of 130 nanometer, and using a variety of enhancement techniques such as optical proximity correction or using immersion lithography, we have been able to extend it down to 65 nanometer node. But even using pushing it to its very limit, it still runs out of steam at 65 nanometer node. And the next generation of wavelength, which is in the extreme ultraviolet range, is has a wavelength of 30 nanometer, but it's not supposed to be ready till it's not supposed to intersect the industry roadmap till the 10 or 7 nanometer node. So the question is, still people have been, we have all heard announcements of, 45 nanometer node, 32 nanometer node, 22 nanometer node, and even down here, nobody is, none of the major player is raising a red flag saying that, lithography is not ready and we are not ready for 50 nanometer node. So the question is, how have been people been able to print dimensions lower than what is possible with the given lithography, and they see a roadmap forward to. So how is that possible? So the answer to that is using a technique called double patterning, and there's a it's a very well established technique, and there's a roadmap forward for this technique to enable future technology nodes, so which I'll talk about in this video.
So what does double patterning mean? To put it very simply, what it means is, suppose I have a pattern of lines which has a pitch of say in this case 60 nanometers. So the spacing between these set of lines, which is the minimum spacing allowable by 130 nanometer lithography, is say 60 nanometer. What double patterning means is now that if I overlay these set of lines, if I overlay them with another pattern of line which has a pitch of 60 nanometer, so I overlay these green lines with these set of blue lines, the key term being overlay. So if I pattern another set of lines which have again the minimum distance between these blue lines is again 60 nanometer, but now I get the distance between these green and blue lines to be half of that, so I get a pitch of 30 nanometer between these two set of lines. And so that's in a very simple way, that's what double patterning is. And there could be a multiple ways you can accomplish this, so I'll describe a few of those. So you could do lithography, and then you can etch that pattern. Then you can do lithography of another set of lines, and then you can etch that, which is lithography etch, or LELE. You could also do a lithography of one set of lines, then freeze that pattern, then put another set of pattern of lines, and then etch them together. So this is called litho freeze, litho etch. Or what you can do is you can actually pattern only once, and then so you can pattern one set of lines and then use a set of spacers around that pattern to self-align spacers around that pattern to double your pitch density, which is known as self-aligned double patterning, or SADP. So all of these techniques essentially allow you to double your pitch density, and I'll describe each of them for you.
So let me start with LELE, or litho etch technique. So the cartoon here describes the process flow for double patterning using litho etch technique. And what it essentially entails is that you have two set of materials. Let's say one of them is nitride, the other one is oxide. And what you do is you pattern one layer of resist, and then you pattern them into these lines, and then you etch that pattern into this first layer. So you etch that pattern into your silicon nitride layer, and you remove the rest of the silicon nitride. So now you have this pattern of silicon nitride lines. And what you do next is put another layer of resist and then overlay that pattern with this existing silicon nitride lines. So now you have this pattern from the second layer of resist that you put on. And now you keep this pattern, you also keep the silicon nitride lines that you had patterned from the first layer of resist. And then you etch them together into this silicon oxide layer. So now the silicon oxide layer now has twice the pitch density. So suppose this was a pitch density of X. Now you have, you know, the spacing between the lines is X by 2, or you know, you have twice the pitch density. So, and then you can, you know, you can remove the nitride on the top, or you can remove the resist and you can wash them away, and you get this pattern of silicon on pattern on silicon oxide, which is not twice the density. So what we have essentially done, we have, you know, doubled our pitch density, but at the same time, you know, now we are let's count the number of steps. So, you know, there's one litho step, there's an etch step, there's another litho step, and then there's an etch step, and then there's, you know, it's optional, but you know, you would want to you can, if you want, wash away this silicon nitride layer. So you have, instead of a conventional lithography where you would have one litho step and then, you know, one etch step, now you have, actually you have, in this case, five steps as we just counted. So you have increased the number of steps involved. Another, you know, another concern, another major concern becomes the overlay. So when you have, when you are patterning the second set of lines, it's very important that, you know, they align, or they line exactly in between the first set of lines. So a major concern then becomes overlay. So LELE is not the only game in town. There are, you know, other techniques you can use to achieve double patterning as well. So let's look at another one of them. So this is called LFLE, or litho freeze litho etch. So what you do in this technique is you pattern one set of lines using you know, one layer of resist, and then you make sure that you freeze this pattern. You don't etch this pattern immediately into the layer below, but you freeze this pattern in the resist. So what it means is that if you do any further wet processing or any further development steps, it should not affect this set of lines, set of pattern resist lines. And what you do is then next apply another layer of resist. So this is, you know, the second layer of resist. And then you do another lithography step, another exposure step. And you pattern another set of lines, but you still have the set of lines, set of resist lines from the first patterning step. So since you have frozen that step, it still does not go away. And you have now, you know, these two sets of resist lines, and then you can etch them together into this hard mass material. Let's say it's oxide. Now you can, you know, etch this set of lines together into this material, and now again what you have achieved is you have doubled your pattern density, or you know, you have reduced your pitch by half as compared to the litho etch techniques that I described before that had, you know, five steps. But this one, as we counted it, you know, it has one litho step, then one freeze step, then another litho step, and then a final etch step. So it has, you know, it has slightly less, one step less as compared to the LELE technique. And but you know, it has its own set of challenges as well. So, you know, resist selectivity becomes very important over here. And you know, as you can imagine, overlay was an issue for LELE as well, but it becomes, you know, even a greater issue for the litho freeze technique.
So moving on, let's talk about the hottest kid in the town in the field of double patterning. So that's this technique called self-aligned double patterning, or SADP. And what it entails is essentially you pattern one set of lines, and this is, you know, often called a dummy pattern, or another word that people use for this is mandrel. So, which comes from a Latin word which means a mold material to form another set of, to a molding material to form a pattern. And that's exactly what it does. So what you do next is, on top of this dummy pattern or mandrel, you deposit a conformal layer of dielectric, let's say again silicon nitride, and then you etch it back. So, you know, this is a conformal layer, so you had a pattern like this, and you deposited a conformal layer of dielectric on top, so it became something like this. So when you etch this off, you would etch, and you know, it will start etching from everywhere, and you will be essentially, you will etch this off, you will etch this off, and what you would be left with essentially is a set of spacer lines. So what you would be left with these spacer lines once you do this etch process. So that's what is shown here. Once you deposit this conformal layer and etch, you form these spacers. And now you can remove your mandrel or your mold material. So you can remove that out. And what you're left with essentially is these set of spacers. And now they have twice the density of, as compared to this dummy pattern. So they have, you know, they have half the pitch or twice the density as compared to this mandrel layer. And then you can etch the spacer into this, say, oxide Haas mask, and then you can etch them further on. So what you essentially achieve is, using this self-aligning spacers which align to your dummy layer or your mandrel, you can double your pattern density. So contrasting SADP to the other techniques that we discussed, that is LELE or LFLE, the advantages of SADP is clearly, you know, it requires only one lithography step. So as you know, the most expensive tool in your fab is your lithography tool, and you know, one of the most expensive steps is to do lithography using that tool. So as compared to LELE or LFLE, which require, you know, two lithography steps, it requires only one lithography step, so that is an advantage. And also, since you require only one lithography step, you don't have to worry about overlaying your two lithography step with each other, so that's another advantage. On the disadvantages side, you know, you require, in this case again, you know, if you count the number of steps, you require 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so you require a large number of steps again, which is, you know, true for all double patterning techniques. But you know, overall, you know, that's given these advantage manufacturers, both in the memory and as well as in the logic space, people are commercially using this SADP technique.